Hey everyone!
Hello.
We're back and we are watching Cross Gene. You know, guys, what happened? I was like, okay, let's watch another video. And Ben typed in.
Nuna, you.
And I was like, okay, what is this?
Of
Are they trying to talk to me or what's going on?
course.
But I think they're probably
They're a
old
boy
enough
band.
that
They
they.
want to grab your heart, don't they? Air grab your heart.
Air grab. Because like the title on the YouTube channel is in Korean, so I wouldn't get that it's Nuna Yu. Well, then there you go. I don't know if I'm ready for this. Like
This is, I think, their 2016 comeback, from what I
2016 comeback.
remember.
Okay, well that's fairly recent.
Yeah.
That's fairly recent. Okay, that's what. Do we know what the song is about or anything
It's
inside?
about you, Nuna. If
Okay.
you
That
watch the
song.
video, it should explain it fairly well.
No! No! Okay,
They get a
well.
great head bob going on every song.
Okay, this is a very different style. Again, can this be more poppy?
Exactly.
With these visuals, I was like, are they burning, putting something on fire?
Yeah, like
Let's.
they're gonna kill someone. And then they start
Spoiler
singing.
alert. They
No,
have.
it's
Okay, wait.
They're so badass they came in with paintball guns.
And basketball.
Yeah. Basketball, take your head off with that basketball. And a fire extinguisher.
You know, if something goes wrong, at least they have the fire extinguisher.
Exactly. And a
They
skateboard.
are very safe, at least.
Ooh. Yeah,
Oh.
this video is so silly. Oh,
Oh my God, there are so many things mixed into one in this.
yeah.
There's like the classic boy band standing in like an abandoned building. There's a hint of danger, but a ton of cuteness.
There's a little bit of like Block B very good criminal overtones.
Okay, this is such a
Oh.
classic boy band thing at the moment.
Look at
Oh,
Shin Time,
giving her
baby.
a cute.
He's a gentleman, you see.
Oh no! Oh my God, this is. It's like they are in a video game or something.
Casper with his weird beret choices.
Again, his style doesn't make any sense. Like he looks fiercely at me, Casper,
Casper, yeah. A
and then he
friendly
just like,
ghost. Yeah,
look, that move was so ultimate boy band. And then like you also have the mirrors, so you can see them multiply.
explosions, obviously.
Not entirely sure what they are
Air
doing.
thrusting. Oh, they're trying to save their Nuna, because she's obviously
Are
been
they?
kidnapped
By who? I thought that they are the
by those
kidnappers.
weird thrusty guys in the cardboard hats.
Luckily, here's a guy in a turtleneck to save the day.
Quick, let's save her. Oh wait, she's already saved herself.
Yes.
Girl power.
Luckily, they had time to change their coats while doing
Exactly, they
that.
had a nice shopping trip in
They
the
the
middle of
mission
saving
in
her.
Mission Impossible saving the girl.
So she's gonna scold them for being late. What are you doing, guys? Why have you brought a basketball here? What's wrong with you? What are these stupid hats?
Okay, I'm gonna treat this as a very funny concept without trying to make any sense. Because otherwise, like, you know, there is no extremely coherent storyline or something like, you know, like a learning takeaway or because again, guys, you know, like I think my favorite band is, you know, It's still BTS and, like, you know, Super Junior is climbing up. but I do like many other artists, and I listen to a lot of indie and a lot of whatever. I keep sending it to the guys. But anyway, so for me, I always look for a story, or I always look for like some sort of messaging in these things. But this is just pure fun, and everything that we've seen with Cross Gene so far, it was just pure lighthearted fun in a kind of weird, sometimes disturbing way. Isn't it?
Sounds like Cross Gene.
But it's just like, it was very, very, you know, lighthearted. And again, like, I am tempted to try to read things into this, which sometimes I think K-pop fans, we can be, you know, we can go overboard about, okay, this means that and whatever. And usually 15
pages
doesn't mean,
of theories on a video music
video. It doesn't mean, sometimes it doesn't mean anything, guys. Anyway, so, but in this one, I am not going to read anything into this. Either the doing exercises when the girl, you know, scolds them for being late or whatever. It's just pure-hearted fun. And I find that very refreshing. You see, because I was, you know, looking for something dark and, you know, heartbreaking and probably that's why I enjoyed Super Junior as well as that much, like early Super Junior, just like, life couldn't get better.
Like, sometimes you need that positivity.
It's like, yay, life couldn't get better. I mean, it could.
It absolutely
it's so
could.
But also, yeah, like, what do you think it's the, if, like, the defining characteristic of Cross Gene?
Members or their songs?
Like, I don't know, like, what would you be your, as you as a Cross Gene fan.
Yeah, they're just, I go to them when I need a bit of a pick-me-up, when I need something catchy. I don't need to read anything into it. I just put on one of their music videos and have a good laugh.
And again, it's...
Some of their stuff's so cheesy you have to laugh. Some of it's, like, just really catchy and makes you smile. I probably had a big dumb smile on my face most of the way through these videos.
I think, again, people don't necessarily realize, like, not everybody can do cheesy well, or not everybody can do cuteness well. I think it's hard not to be, you know, cringy, or it's hard not to,
usually it is cringy anyway.
I don't think I can act really cute, for example. So it's like it's a specific talent, I think, and it seems that members of this group all have that talent, that they can turn into this, like, comedic character without feeling forced. So I think that's a very special and important appeal that they have. And so they debuted in 2012, we heard.
Then they changed a member 1 year in. So Seong, who you probably saw singing most of the choruses there, he wasn't in at the debut. They used to have a Chinese member called JQ, I think was his name. And he left off, like, the first album to go solo in China. So he went, and then we've had Seong ever since, and Seong is the oldest member and the main vocalist.
I found it very interesting.
Casper left last year as well. So down to five members now.
I found it very interesting. Did the first member who left found success in China?
I'm not sure, actually. I've not looked him up.
Because I keep learning about EXO with Ksenia, obviously, and then, like, you know, step by step, it's still so much to learn. But, like, I'm totally getting into it with, you know, people like Lay.
You like a bit of Lay.
I think he's just a very cool person. And I'm watching Ideal Producer, and I have to tell you guys that by far the best thing about Ideal Producer is the teachers, including Lay and Jackson is there, and also amazing, you know, two girl group members.
Is that one that Cheng Chao's on?
I think Wonder Girls, one of Wonder Girls members is there.
Oh, is it one of the WJSN girls was on that, right?
I might have
a different show, I'm not sure.
I think so. But and then also there is a very well-respected Chinese singer who's just training the guys. Anyway, what I wanted to, you know, say with this, that you guys, we mention all the time this music and pop culture professor, kind of friend of ours, who was a teacher on the K-Pop Academy. And she was talking about recently, when we had a drink with her, And she invited us, by the way. It was amazing. Oh, nice. Like, because she was like, oh, I'm the senior here. She's a Korean lady. And then she was like, oh, guys, so I'm going to buy you guys drinks. I felt so weird. Because again, like...
Dr. Arms treated you like, drinks.
In the area where I grew up, like in Hungary, like it's almost obsessive how people are always counting the money. Like, okay, so I owe you 1.20... whatever pounds, and there you go. So it's like it's a completely different culture, so I felt a bit uncomfortable. It's just one of those very nice culture clash moments. But anyway, so she was talking about the Chinese market and like how it's maturing at the moment. It's still, you know, kind of young when it comes to, you know, pop music in China, and obviously the politics are a bit complicated. But I was just wondering, did that member find success or not?
I'm not sure.
I would love to, you know,
come up.
I don't know. Let's try, because I'm curious.
I didn't find anything when I was looking into the group before. I didn't find anything on Wikipedia for him, really. So probably he's not been that successful.
Well, guys, you guys, let us know in the comments, because it's always interesting to see what happens with the members that, you know, that stay, and obviously what happens with the members that, you know, go off solo. And obviously we wish him the best, and we wish all of them the best. Because it's a huge market and it's full of talented people. And again, Cross Gene is just another example of that. Thank you so much, Ben, for this introduction. I found it... This is a very unique band, and I think I get why you like them. And it definitely sounds a bit like Infinite. Which
was, you think so?
Yeah, just like it has a very pop element. Like a very strong pop element.
I like my poppy pop.
Poppy pop. Guys, let us know what you think. What are your favorite hidden secret bands that not so many people like?
Snooper.
Well, we could do like a Snooper reaction too. Let us know what you think. And thank you, Ben, for joining us for this 3-part episode. And, you know, give us feedback, give us comments, and let's spread the love on as many bands and many artists as possible. See you guys soon.
See you later.